let's just keep it Odegaard, Caicedo, to be honest here today. And I'm not going to start looking at these play both games so far. So I'm playing Spurs, who have kind of been our developed rival throughout the 3 years we've done. So, let's see if we can take another one. The first home game of the year, it's the home opener. First time wearing the purple jerseys, I think. Unless I'm colorblind and we wore them last episode, but I'm pretty sure we wore the reds and then the whites. There's a lot of time without a goal this year, but it's fine. As Mudryk is here. Mudryk, over one. Both games started with Ollie's second in goals, so we'll see if that happens again. Cat is meowing at Ortonk, and I don't know what's going on. Oh, what a Ruben in the back. We're at a backdoor Ruben there. There you go. Nice work. Turns around for an offensive play. At least, you're not on sides, Zlatan. Guard. But I, shoots. Saved by Sommer. Yeah, I don't know, guys. Should we build a new stadium? Because, you know, now that we, our team valuation is up to $1 billion. Should we build a new stadium? Or should we kind of keep our little home we have? Hey. Hey now. Okay, that's off of Antonio Silva. Spurs are going to play that better, probably. Yeah, I mean, our team is pretty good this year. You know, we're keeping up in 1v1s. We're playing well in the midfield. We're getting good scoring chances, and here's another one. Odegaard to Olise. Can it be deja vu again? Oh no. Let's see. If Olise gets a goal, or if Olise gets the opening goal of every game, that's going to be hilarious. Spurs have a good chance here. What a save. That was wasted by Spurs. They should just let that go out for the corner. Interesting decision so far. What a card to Elise. Now Modric. Okay, Anthony in the back. Anthony. Elise. Oh, well, how does Elise not score that? Oh, my. I mean, it was a lot at once, but that was the chance to take the lead. Here's Harry Kane. Good stuff. Oh, that's been right. Oh, no, it's not. He kept his footing. There we go. because they have Virgil van Dijk. I guess Spurs are really trying this year. I love they've got a good team. There's no doubt about it. Sato. certainly felt like we could have lost this game. We could have lost the Villa game, but we didn't. So, but we didn't win this one. It's a 0-0 draw at home. I mean, Messi made some incredible saves. Look, 16 shots, but their XG wasn't very high. We probably could have won. Maybe given XG, we should have won, but every other stat kind of went to them. So, yeah, not the greatest. Whoa, Sheffield and West Ham 3-4. You don't see that often by the computer. But okay. I don't want to use this. I want to go. Yeah, give him my club team. Thank you. So we have 24 million. I want to maybe think about a backup quarterback. It's not something we really need too much, but I want to use the money that's been given. Come on. First team called it. So really any of these, let's see if we can bring in a Ganji. Even Joe Roden I'm fine with. Arsenal man Smalling. Let's take a look at that. Oh yeah, we could bring back Antoine Dubois. If you remember him. Yeah. Let's do that. Let's bring our boy home, Antoine Dubois. If you remember him from season one, he was the first guy we ever sold for money. We sold him for like $4 million, and it appears that's what he's worth. That is just full circle. I mean, I needed, I needed somebody who could come in defensively for us if we needed to take out Silva or Sole. Sorry, what else? Scheduled matchups there. Alright, let's just skip deadline day from here then. Looks like Varane is gonna go to either Chelsea or City. We got the World Cup at the end of this year, of course, so we'll be playing that. But as far as these goes, we're just gonna sim them. Alright, died Scotland. Ahmad Adman and Morales. not too worried because honestly, like when I go to play with them, I'll be better. Oh, I see that we got our Champions League pool. I saw a Red Bull team in there. Have the cup games been decided yet? Nope. Carabao Cup, we've got Watford. Okay, Champions League, let's take a look. Group A, City, Inter, Salzburg, Porto, that's a tough group. Group B, Chelsea, Atletico, PSV. And a made-up team. Well, not made-up team, but, you know, FC Basel. Not too bad of a group there. PSG, Real Madrid, Roma, and Shakhtar, another tough group. Villarreal, Marseille, Latium, and Ajax. That's probably the easiest group so far. Villarreal, of course, won over us last year. Besides that, though, I mean, Marseille, probably get that. Dortmund, Sevilla, Fenerbahce, and whatever. I don't even want to try to say it. That's an easy group for sure. That will be Sevilla and Dortmund. Bayern and Leicester. Racing Club in Monaco. Interesting, so Leicester's got a good chance to get out of that. Here's our group. Rangers, Benfica, Leipzig, and us. So we played Leipzig last year. And, no, we played Salzburg last year. Benfica's a good team. Rangers. It's not too tough. I don't think we'll have any issues. It should be between Leipzig and Benfica for a second. And you got the Barca, Juventus, Hoffenheim, and Royal. Just want to look at the other English teams in the other groups. So Spurs have a group with Wolfsburg, Hearts, and the Europa League. And Villa have Ajax, Lech, and Malmo. And then the seventh place team. Napoli's in there in the Conference League. Brugge's in the Man United. Yeah, they got an easy group. Cool. All right. Well, we got the West Ham Hammers. West Ham United. Let's just finish this episode with a nice, simple win. I mean, the last two games, we escaped with 4 points. When we really didn't look like it. So let's just get to business. Let's get it done. We're on the road again. Like I said, 4 games into the season. We've played one home game. But obviously, what comes around goes, or whatever it is, what comes around. We will have, you know, we'll have 3 extra home games at a point. Oh yeah, it's Liquid Bubble FC. Won't score. We don't have to see the bubbles again until the end of the half. Here's the trick. Drops it off. What do we say? Over the bar. So, every game that we've scored a goal, Olise has been the first to do it. Olise scored the first goal against Wolves. Olise scored the first goal against Villa. We didn't score any goals last game, so that is still up. That, you know, that record or whatever. Whatever you want to call it, that tendency, that scenario is still true. Here's Anthony Robinson. Zlatan. We got Modric. Oh, it's deflected. Odegaard. Modric, put it in. Goal, Modric. There goes Elise's, scenario. Still, that means Olise has 3 goals and Modric has 3 goals and nobody else has any. It's been the Modric and Olise show, those two outside guys. Lindqvist coming off, or Zlatan Jr. coming off of his golden boot. Doesn't have a goal yet through 4 games. Zlatan. Modric. Olise. players to score before Zlatan Jr., but the initial save from Olise was made, and Odegaard's there to clean up his leftovers. They left Olise had three Pop-Tarts, didn't finish the third one. Odegaard came in and finished it, and that was the winning Pop-Tart, you know? This is exactly what I wanted from this game, though, just after a not-so-great last two games, even though we didn't lose. Just get ourselves back on track against West Ham, who we know can score. They just scored four goals in their last game against the Sheffield. Zlatan, there's Zlatan's goal off the corner. He got quite a few of those last year, and he's now the fourth different player to score for us. Let's go. You know, last year we probably had 20 different players score for us. That's how diverse we were. I think Dubois will make his debut today, or should I say, you know, not even debut, I should honestly just say, like, his return. He's already played for the team before. That was nice. Say deflected. Zlatan, you beauty. What a shot. Shot. What a shot. And after not scoring the first three games, he's got two through four, basically. Let's bring in Lake Dubois for the final a little bit. And Rizzo hasn't played yet, so let's put in Rizzo. Alright, making his return, Antoine Dubois. Has got a goal in every game. We've got a goal. Boom. Fourth goal of the year for Michael Olise. Doesn't matter if he's not getting better because he's perfectly fine the way he is. Just keep throwing him to the floor. Well, Dubois makes a mistake. That leads to a goal, right? It's not like a mistake, it was just not a great position. Dude, they have three goals. West Ham can score. It's 5-3. And they just scored four goals last game. Liquid FC. Oh, we might have six. Patrick Brazada. Well, I guess it really wasn't a clean game we wanted in the end, though. Still a 5-goal game, but we only won by 2. Well, very entertaining episode nonetheless. We underperformed, they outperformed, according to XG. Zlatan with 2 goals, Olise and Mudryk with a goal and an assist apiece, Odegaard with 2 assists and a goal. And yeah, the ball came in and put up a 5.7. Only 10 minutes of a game, so how much does that really?